Generally, whenever we discuss arcade racing games, we see these few names come up. That is games like Need for Speed, Burnout, Outrun, and the Forza Horizon series. But today, we are going to talk about a racing game which was set for release in India during 2008. And I personally feel that this game actually had the potential to give the NFS series a run for its money, at least in the domestic Indian market. So hey guys, this is Indian Video Game Collector, and before we head any further, do consider subscribing to my channel for more quality content related to video games. So friends, we have roamed the streets of London, Paris, San Francisco and a lot of other prominent cities in games like Midtown Madness, Midnight Club and Italian Job. But for a moment, just for a moment, sit back and imagine. What if we could indulge and virtually race around one of the Indian cities right from the comfort and safety of our home and experience all the chaos that occur on Indian roads? Imagine driving around the landmarks that you have visited or you walk past every day during your day-to-day commute. All this while dealing with the traffic cops, the loose cattle on the road, the dog menace, and obviously the pothole filled Indian roads, which are always under maintenance. Well friends, Trine Studio had the same idea, and they announced their first PC game way back in 2007, titled Streets of Mumbai. You're standing at a traffic signal, waiting for the lights to change. As a local train pulls past Journey Road station, just as the lights turn green, you step on the gas and a beggar runs across the road. You hit him. Apart from going to the jail, you also lose 100 points over here. So this game was touted as a stereotypical Mumbai with beggars, stray dogs, dug-up roads and the civic bodies, Rukawat ke liye khed hai, or the sorry for the inconvenience signs. And additionally, it also boasted about having Baba Saikal and Sharon Prabhakar who would be hip-hopping in the background. And this game also boasted about racing in cars similar to the ones that were available in the Indian markets back then. And all of this in a fully 3D modeled virtual city. So the city models, especially the roads and the landmarks, were basically 3D mapped with the help of Google Earth satellite images and also images of landmarks taken by Trine employees. And Trine had actually demonstrated this game at the NASCOM Animation Gaming Indian Conference in Mumbai in 2007, where certain attendees also got to try the game firsthand on the demo track. And this was basically a section between the Nariman Point, I believe, as far as my research suggests. Trine Studios mentioned that the game was being developed entirely within India, that is, nothing was outsourced to any other country, and the game was initially slated to be released on PC supporting Windows XP and Vista sometime during the year 2008. Later listings on the website also mentioned the game would be available on PS3 alongside PC. Also, there was a mention of multiplayer support via WiiWare, hinting that they had a plan to launch it for Nintendo Wii. Some of the features of the game listed on the website included the following. Over 7 twin directional track offering a total of 14 playable tracks spanning across various parts of city covering all major areas. Over 10 customizable Indian cars with a variety of customizable options such as paint, spoilers, rims, hoods, lights, side skirts, bumpers and much more. So just imagine what it would be like if you get into a Lancer and then you go ahead and customize it out like crazy. Additionally, it also supported day and night, and there was also a rain theme for extra realism of Mumbai. So the game also had a free roaming mode, but the only problem with that was that you could not actually initiate races from that. You could roam about as much as you want, but to start a race, you would again have to quit the freerun mode and go ahead and initiate a race. There's also a story mode associated with the game. And lastly, they are also planning to have downloadable tracks. So if you get bored of the preset tracks, you can actually go ahead and download the tracks based on nominal fee, and they're also planning to have certain downloadable tracks for free. Lastly, there was a feature of customizable music player, which allowed the player to listen to their own songs while playing. This was a little GTA-esque, if you really ask me. And we have already talked about the realistically detailed environments that are actually references from the imaginary and videos taken by the developer as well as Google Earth. And they also mentioned that the game would support a wide variety of PCs, right from the low end to dedicated gaming machines. So it was available to it would be available to a wider audience, as well as since the game was entirely created in India, they also said that the prices would be affordable. And the next best thing was multiplayer support was available for online play, so you could actually race with your friends online. And they also boasted about realistic car physics as well as a story mode with 10 plus hours of gameplay. So all of this sounds really, really, really exciting on paper. So the point now is, all of this is great. I mean, it's really good. So why haven't we heard a lot about this game? I mean, this should have been really huge, right? So the reason why we haven't really heard about it in recent times or in almost a decade now is that the game's release date kept on being pushed back until Trine stopped providing any updates regarding the game. This was the status quo they maintained until they shut shop in 2013. In the meantime, Trine did work on other projects, the most popular ones being the Street Cricket games and the infamous Bollywood tie-in called Ra 1 that was released on PS2 and PS3. So what were the exact reasons for shelving Streets of Mumbai? Industry insiders mentioned that Trine shelved the project, stating that they were unable to live up to the internal quality requirements. And they started concentrating on the development of Gothic series instead that they were developing for Joe Wood, I believe. Though a year later, industry insiders also mentioned that the game was conceptualized and marketed to create a hype, which would help trying to acquire the funds from VC firms. And once the said firms were acquired, they just started diverting their attention towards other games. So we also looked up on the internet for Streets of Mumbai trademark, and looks like the trademark has expired on 29th of November 2017. Additionally, there's also a comment on an online gaming forum where the said author mentions that he was on the development team of this game and everything was pretty much ready to go. And even he's not sure why the game was shelved. But with Trine going out of business, I don't think this particular project will ever see the light of the day. So until any other company comes up with such a bright idea and actually delivers the game, I think we'll just have these mobile games at our perusal. And that, my friends, was the story of Streets of Mumbai, a game which could have been the rising star of the Indian gaming scene and could have provided some intense competition to the likes of Burnout and Need for Speed, at least locally in the Indian market. If you liked the video, do press the like button and do not forget to share this piece of Indian video game history with your friends and family. I intend to make more such videos in the future, so definitely subscribe. That's it for today. Indian Video Game Collector signing off.